Today we are in network analysis and synthesis lab. Today we'll try to verify Norton's theorem by doing experimentation through a kit available with us. Before starting, let us understand what is Norton's theorem. Basically, a Norton theorem states that any two-terminal linear active bilateral network with resistances, voltage sources, and our current sources can be replaced by a simple equivalent circuit consisting of a single current source in parallel with a single resistance. So, suppose we have a given network of generators and linear impedances connected with a load ZL. So, this entire network can be replaced by equivalent Norton circuit having a Norton current source in parallel with a Norton impedance. So this is all about the Norton theorem. So in order to verify the Norton theorem, we have taken a circuit. For example, this circuit is having a 5 volt DC supply connected with a network of resistances R1, R2, R3, R4, R5. A load resistance is connected across the output terminals of the given circuit. So first of all, we'll try to find out the current flowing through this load resistance by analytical methods. So in order to find the current flowing through this port, we have to calculate Norton equivalent of this given circuit, that is this circuit, from A, B, C, D, E, F, G and H. So for that, we calculate short circuit current through terminals D and E, which will be the Norton current equivalent. And in order to calculate Norton resistance, we'll replace all the energy sources by their internal resistances or impedances. In this particular case, we have an ideal voltage source, so this voltage source will be short circuited, and we'll have an equivalent circuit like this. This terminal short circuited, having resistances at their places. So, looking into the terminals, we can calculate the Norton equivalent resistance. These are R1, R2, R3, R4, and R5. So, after calculation, we get Norton equivalent resistance equal to 674 ohms. Okay, after doing some calculation, because these two are in parallel combination, again R3 and the parallel combination of these two are in series. So, and at this point, this equivalent of the entire circuit is in parallel with R4, and ultimately the total equivalent of this network is in series with R5. So in this way we can calculate Rn, that is 674 ohms. So in order to calculate this Norton equivalent current through the terminals, we have to short these terminals, and this is your I Norton, and we'll replace this energy source 5 volt supply for you. So in this particular circuit we have 3 loops, loop number 1, loop number 2 and loop number 3. We consider currents I1, I2 and I3 flowing in these loops, respective loops. So by the application of mesh analysis, we can easily find out the currents I1, I2 and I3. So for that, we usually write the linear equations for meshes 1, 2 and 3. So after writing these mesh equations, I am not going deep into the analysis. We have obtained this kind of matrix that is having coefficient as 782, minus 5, 6, 2, 0, minus 5, 6, 2, 1, 2, 7, 3, minus 5, 11, 0, minus 5, 11, 9, 8, 1 as equivalent coefficient matrix. This is our column matrix of currents I1, I2 and I3, and this is energy source equivalent matrix, column matrix 500. So with the help of Cramer's rule, you can easily find out I1, I2, I3, and this I3 gives not an equivalent circuit because IN is equal to I3. This branch current is equal to I3. So I3 will give the equivalent Norton current source. So in this case, we have analyzed this kind of circuit in MATLAB also. We have written the column matrix A, X and D. We are considering this as B matrix, this as X matrix, this as A matrix. So as per convention, AX is equal to B in matrix notation. So X will be equal to A backslash B, or you can say X is equal to A inverse B. So in matrix formulation, we can obtain various currents I1, I2, I3 with the help of MATLAB simulation. We have written matrix A in this form. A is equal to 782 minus 562 0 semicolon, then other element semicolon, then last element, and put a semicolon over here. So this is your matrix A, coefficient matrix A. This is your coefficient matrix A. Similarly, matrix B, that is column matrix representing energy sources. This is your matrix B, and this is your solution of the matrix, solution matrix. Okay, so once we have written this code in MATLAB, we can run it by just pressing F5 key. We can run it by pressing this icon, or you can just press F5 key, and you will have results of X matrix, which is having values of I1, I2 and I3. So let us press F5. Now you can see that command window is showing X equal to first element as 0.0107, that is equal to I1. I2 is equal to 0.0060, I3 is equal to 0.0031. So this I3 is equal to Norton current source, equivalent Norton current source. This is 3.1 milliampere. So this I Norton is equal to 3.1 milliampere. Okay. So now we'll replace the entire circuit by equivalent Norton circuit having a current source like this. IN equal to 3.1 milliampere and a parallel resistance RN having value 672 ohms or 674 ohms. Now we will connect a load across the terminals, given load. And in this way, we can find out the current flowing through the load resistor. So this thing will perform on the kit. We have kit for verification of Norton theorem, and other theorems also can be verified. So today we'll learn how to perform Norton theorem verification. So as you can see that this particular circuit, this kit is having a power supply source for this kit. In this kit we have inbuilt power supplies of plus 5 volt and plus 12 volts. Here we have a circuit that we drawn over here on the board. This circuit is having a connection for power supply, DC power supply. Various resistances R1, R2, R3, R4, R5 are connected, and a load resistor, variable load resistor is also connected over here. So in order to find out the equivalent Norton circuit, we will try to calculate Norton current by short circuiting the load terminals and by measuring this current IN. The second step is to find out the Norton equivalent resistance by replacing this power supply connection by a short circuit and measuring the resistance value by a multimeter across the terminals 1 and 3. So let us do the things. So in first step, plus volt power supply with VCC terminal of the given circuit, the ground terminal of the power supply with the ground terminal of the given circuit. Then we'll connect a meter at point 1. The negative terminal of the meter is connected at point number 3. So in this way you can see that the reading of ammeter is showing 3.2 milliamperes. So this is our 3. Measured IN is equal to 3.2 milliamperes. Now we'll try to measure RN, that is equivalent Norton resistance. So in order to measure Norton resistance, we have to replace the energy source, that is voltage source, by a short circuit. So we'll short these two points plus VCC and ground terminals of the given circuit, and with the help of multimeter we can measure the resistance across the terminals 1 and 3. This will give us equivalent Norton resistance, that is 672 ohms. So we'll write here 672 ohms, right? Now in the third case we'll try to measure the load current through the circuit, through the load. So we'll make connections of power supply again by connecting plus 5 volt supply with VCC terminal of the given circuit and ground terminal of the power supply with the ground terminal of the given circuit, and we'll make connections for the ammeter. Ammeter will be connected, the positive terminal is connected with point 1 and negative terminal of the ammeter is connected with point 2. So this will give the reading of 1.3 milliamperes. So the load current in this case is 1.3 milliamperes. So we'll record this as measured load current 1.3 milliamperes. So in this way we have measured the Norton current equivalent Norton resistance. We have taken load resistance as 874 ohms and we have measured load current equal to 1.3 milliampere. So now we have an equivalent circuit of this given circuit like this. The equivalent circuit has a current source of 3.1 milliampere and a parallel resistance 680 ohms. So we have connected a load terminal, same load having 874 ohms value is connected over here. We have taken 874 ohms load, and in this case we'll try to measure the load current in this circuit. So in order to measure the load current, what we will do, we'll connect these terminals, the current source terminals, like this. Point number 4 and 5 are connected, point 8 and 9 are connected like this, and we'll try to measure the current through the load by connecting point number 7 of the load with the negative terminal of the ammeter and point number 6 with the positive terminal of the ammeter. So in this case we are getting some fluctuation, we are getting 1.3 ampere, 1.4 ampere, so on average we can take 1.3 ampere. So this IL is 1.3 milliampere. These values are already available, otherwise you can measure the values of this circuit. You can measure the current source, the value of the current source like this. You can check how much current is coming from this source, constant current source. You can observe that we are having 3.4, 3.5 milliampere. So this is IN is 3.3 milliampere in this case. Some variations may be there due to tolerances with the resistive and inductor parts. And you can also measure this load resistance value by a multimeter. You can put the meter over here like this. You can put multimeter like this and you will get the value equal to 673.74 like this. So this is 672 ohms. So in this way you can observe that the measured load current in for the given circuit is 1.3 milliampere, and the equivalent circuit, equivalent Norton circuit, is also giving the load current equal to 1.3 milliampere. So in both the cases load current is same. So we can say that the given circuit and the equivalent circuit, equivalent Norton circuit, verifies each other, and in this way we have verified Norton's theorem. This is all about the verification of Norton's theorem. Thank you very much.